There's a couple different ways to create a Google spreadsheet. You can either do it from scratch, which is what we'll do first, or you can create it from a template, or you may have a spreadsheet already that you want to get into Google Drive and then open it in Sheets, and we'll go over that as well. So the way to just create a blank Google Sheet is to start out by going to drive.google.com. This is Google Drive. If you don't have an account, a Google account already, then you'll have to create one, but let's assume that you have one. And go to a blank area that's in where your files and folders are. I'm going to right click, and Google Sheets is one of the options. If you go over to the right, you'll see that you can do it from a blank spreadsheet or a template. So if you wanted to do something common, like maybe a budget or create an invoice for a customer, there'll be a template for that that'll get you started. But right now we're just going to do a blank spreadsheet. So you'll see it opened a new window with your Google Sheet spreadsheet in it. Google Drive is still open in the background, and it'll look exactly like this if you're using Google Chrome as your browser. But if you're using another one, it'll still do the multiple tabs. It'll be similar. And the first thing that you probably want to do is name it something that's meaningful to what it's going to be. So let's just assume that you're doing inventory. Name it inventory. You're ready to go. There's a few basics about how to do this. So you're only in one cell at a time if you're entering data. And it starts out in A1. You reference these by saying the column first and then the row. And type what you want in here. Maybe this will be the amount. And to go down, you either hit enter or you hit the down arrow. Typically, you would just hit enter, which will always bring you down. But sometimes you may want to go left, right, up, down, and just use arrow keys. Right now, I'm going to hit the down arrow, and that's done. You've entered your first data in a Google spreadsheet. So let's enter a few numbers in here just to show you what you might want to do next. We'll do 3, 4, and 3. And then if you want to sum them, go to insert function, and it's going to have the most common functions here. This is going to be what you're using a lot of the time, and just choose sum, left click on it, and it wants the range of the values. So we're working in A2 all the way through A4, and you've also could have just used your mouse, left clicked in A2 and dragged it down to A4, and now hit enter. And you've done your first spreadsheet function. It's adding up 3, 4, and 3. So that's how you create a blank spreadsheet. It's pretty easy. The key is just remember to go to your Google Drive, create it from there, give it a good name, and then you can find it later. So I'm going to show you the steps on how to upload an existing spreadsheet. So one of the little tricks that you want to do is you want to go to your settings and make sure Convert Uploads is checked. If that's not checked, it's going to upload it, say in this case, in a Excel format. It's going to sit on your Google Drive in a non-native format. So if you put it on Google Drive to use in Sheets, just have this checked and it'll convert it for you automatically. Now that you want to upload your file, go to New and File Upload. And this is going to look at the hard drive on your computer. I happen to have put mine here. So this is the sample data. This is an Excel spreadsheet. Select it, click open. And you see in the lower right-hand corner, it's uploading one item. It has this X here, which is saying that it's in Excel. But if you see by the time it gets into my drive, it's in Google Sheets. If you didn't click that check mark that I showed you a minute ago, this would still be an X and you could view it, but it wouldn't be in the native format. So if I open up sample data, it'll open up in Google Sheets and it's ready to go. See, but it doesn't always upload perfectly. In this example, the header just looks black. If I click in, say, example C1, I can see there's a value in there, but what it did was it turned my fonts black and the background black. So let's just go and turn the text color to white and we can see what's happening here. So that's your three ways to create a new sheet. Make a blank sheet, create one from a template, or upload existing data. Next, we're going to go through how to format it. And so hang on for that. If you want more videos like this, be sure to subscribe to my channel. Thanks.